Can Google Calendar be used as an effective to-do list? Absolutely. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up Google Calendar to be a very effective to-do list. I'm also going to show you how to use this on the mobile version of Google Calendar. And last but not least, I'm going to cover the pros and cons of using Google Calendar as your to-do list. But I think what you're going to find out is that the pros far outweigh the cons. But first, I'd like to thank today's sponsor, Hostinger. If you're an entrepreneur or a small business owner, you know how important it is to have web hosting which is fast and reliable. And Hostinger has plans for almost everyone. Whether you're a small or a large business, they have a solution for you. In fact, CNET.com just gave them a rating of 4.5 out of 5 when listing their best web hosting services of 2019. Now, if you'd like to get an additional 15% off, just go to hostinger.com/simpletivity or see the link below. So let me show you three different ways on how you can set this up within your calendar. The first one that we're looking at here is pretty basic, and that is using the all-day events area to create new tasks. So I'm just going to create a simple sample task here, new task one. And I'm just going to hit save. It's going to appear here in my all task area. I can see that I want to do this tomorrow on Tuesday, but I can quickly and easily drag it and move it to some other day. And what I love about this technique, about using it here in my calendar, is I can see the relationship between this task and all of my tasks alongside my other appointments and where I need to be. So for example, maybe I'm having a heavy day today. I'm not sure if I can get through all of these tasks, and I'm saying to myself, well, I don't want to really review this this resume that I have to. I'd like to move that out to maybe Thursday or Friday. But then wait a minute, I'm actually interviewing someone on Wednesday. I can't push it out that far. Maybe I can push it out till Tuesday. I can see that relationship and make decisions based on that. So again, what we want to do is using the all-day events area. Simply click on that area and you can start adding a new task right away. And whatever it is, it's going to appear in that all-day task area. And even if you think that you can't add all the same details as you would in another to-do list, well, hold on just a second. By hitting the edit button in any of these tasks, you can add not just a location, but of course use this description area to add bullet points, to add an attachment. You can even change the color of this task if you want to highlight it in some other way. Well, that brings me to the second method that we can use with managing our tasks here within the calendar, and that is that you can have a separate calendar just for your task. So here I've created one here called to-do list, and I'm going to enable that. And what you can see here is that I've added a few other tasks here. Because remember, some of our tasks will be included as a part of our day. Maybe this is something really important, recording this new video, and I need to make sure it happens Thursday morning. But here's another example that I have up above. It's labeled in this green shade or this green color, which I've selected. So I can separate out my tasks from everything else. That's a second method if you want to actually keep it on a separate calendar. Of course, Google Calendar makes this very, very easy for you to do so. All you need to do is just say, add new calendar, and then you can add as many calendars as you want. And of course, toggle through those calendars here on the left-hand side. Now, the third way that you can implement having a to-do list within Google Calendar is to make use of the actual tasks function or tasks app, which is built right into Google Calendar. So you'll notice on the right-hand side, you have the tasks functionality here where you can create tasks. You can check them off directly from this side menu. And in order to see them here on your calendar, all you need to do is enable tasks here on the left-hand side. So here you can see I've got about three tasks aligned this week. They align with these ones that we see here. Now, the one thing you want to be careful with is that although it makes sense to be managing your tasks, and if I drag this task over to Thursday, for example, that is going to be reflected. There you see that it moved over here on the right as well. However, when we switch to the mobile version, you're going to notice something. these are not going to appear, because on the mobile version, these are not integrated into Google Calendar. You have to manage them within the Google Tasks app. So be wary of that. You may or may not like that as a part of your workflow. Now, one other thing that you can always add to enhance your to-do list here within Google Calendar is the reminders feature. So I'm going to enable the reminders feature, and here you see I've got a couple that appear. Now, what is the difference between reminders and tasks and the all-day event tasks which we have created here? Well, reminders will always carry over. So if I don't complete this particular reminder on Monday, it is going to carry over to Tuesday. I'm going to have to address it eventually and check things off. Reminders can be day-specific or time-specific, as you see down below here. And if you don't know how to create a reminder, let me show you how to do so. If I want to create a reminder here, let's say at 9 a.m. on Wednesday, all I need to do is click on that space, and instead of starting to add the title of this event, I'm going to first click Reminder. You can see just below the title, Event is the default selection, but I'm going to select Reminder. And so now I can add in a new reminder here, and I can just hit Enter on my screen, and there I've got that reminder. Now, if I want to change this reminder to an all-day reminder, I can do so as well. All I need to do is select it, hit the Edit button, and now I can select the all-day option. And here you can see that that reminder now appears here at the top of my list. Now, one caveat I'm going to talk about a little bit later on in the video is one of the things that you need to watch for. But before I do that, let's jump to the mobile version of Google Calendar. All right, so here we are within Google Calendar on our mobile device. And as you can see at the top of the screen, I have my all-day tasks. Technically, they're all-day events, but I'm using them as tasks at the top of my screen. And what I love about this is that whether it's early in the morning or if I scroll all the way to the end of the day, those tasks always remain visible. They're always at the forefront. If I scroll over here to the next day, here you see I have a combination of tasks, appointments, and a couple of reminders as well. So if you want to add a new task within Google Calendar, we're going to hit the plus button in the bottom right hand corner of the screen, and we're going to select event, because remember, we're using all day events. So here I'm just going to call this one task 2, and the only thing you need to keep in mind at this point is that we want to hit the all day toggle. Unless you want this task to appear at a specific time, you want to select all day and hit save, and now that task will appear at the top of your screen. Now, if we want to add a reminder, again, we're going to start with that plus button, but this time we're going to select the reminder option. Let me just type in a quick reminder, let's call this one reminder 3. And if I want it at a specific time, I can select that here. I can select this to be at 8:30, for example, or I can hit the all day option, and again, it will be all day as well. Now, don't forget, you may need to hit the down arrow here to reveal all of your tasks. Now, this will stay sticky, meaning that the last time you've selected it or chosen that option, it's going to remain that way. So here you can see I have a few reminders that I need to look at along with all of my tasks. Now, this is one of the, I guess, both pro and con of using reminders. Here you can see that it will never combine your all-day events. We can see them listed out individually, but you will notice here that it has combined my reminders. I've got two here. If I select it, I can now read and see those two, but you cannot, by default, expand those reminders. Lastly, I want to cover some of the pros and cons of using Google Calendar as your to-do list. Now, I've already highlighted the pros of seeing your tasks up above and always having them stay in the forefront as you go about your day. But one of the things that you want to watch out for is that, of course, these all-day events, which we are using as tasks, will not roll over. At the end of today, these two green tasks will not roll over to Tuesday like this reminder will. Now, this is a con, but in some ways, psychologically, it's also a pro. And what I mean by that is that it forces you to engage with your calendar and specifically with your to-do list. Too many of us don't engage with our to-do list often enough, and then after a day or two, we end up deferring a large number of tasks to the very next day. Well, in this case, this sort of forces you at the end of your workday or at the very end of your day to review what is left over and have it move over, drag it over to a more appropriate day where you can accomplish that task. I hope you enjoyed today's overview of using Google Calendar as a to-do list, and I would love to hear your experience as well, so be sure to leave me a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. Give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to leave me a comment down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.